Welcome to the easy subnetting chart, subnetting cheat chart. So in the exam you can draw some lines on your little board that they give you, a little whiteboard. And you just start off in the top right hand column with number 1 and you keep doubling it until you get to the number 128. So this will be one octet, which is 8 binary places. So these are the only possible values for each subnet. And then in the left hand column, you will start off with the first value, so if you like you can put a tick in the 1 to 8 column, which as you can clearly see here gives you 128. Add 64 gives you 192, and we keep ticking along each column until we get to the end. So these are our possible subnet values, and hopefully these numbers in the left column will look familiar to you. Now this is just how to actually write the column. You won't be ticking along the top when you when you've got used to writing out this particular chart. And this will allow you to, using the tick system, answer any subnetting question or any network design question quickly in your exam. So we get to 255, which is the last possible value. Now in the bottom, this is our design area, which we'll refer to if we're asked how many subnets or how many hosts. And all we do is add the powers of 2 together. 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, all the way down. You'll stop until you get to the relevant number for whatever question you're being asked. For this example, I'm just going to stop at 256, but obviously you could keep going. Now there's two columns we're going to need here, one for our subnets and one for our hosts, and we have to take two away for our host value, one for the subnet and one for the broadcast. Thanks for watching the video. Please go over to howtonetwork.com, check out all our IT certification courses, practice exams, and live Cisco racks. There's a $1 coupon in the description. Welcome to our next example. So our which subnet is host, it should say 172, which I will fix in a moment, .16.100.129/29 in. Now, novice subnetters will be put off by the fact it's a Class B address with a more than a Class C mask. Don't worry about it. In the exam, all we're concentrating on is the octet that we're subnetting in, which is the last octet. Now, if you were working out design, you would have to start off 172.16.0.0. We don't have time for that in the exam. We just want to find out which subnet this IP address is in. So we've stolen how many bits from the last octet? Well, it's 5. If you add 5 to /24, you get 29. So we tick down 5, and you can see in longhand, if you wanted to write it out, it's .248. So if we tick down 5, we tick across 5, giving us our subnet increment, which is 8. Now, in order to get to .129, it's going to take ages to count up in increments of 8. So we'll do a little cheat and we're going to jump up in increments larger than 8, but multiples of 8, if you get what I mean. So we could do 8 to 80 or 8 to 40, because we know if we keep counting up in 8s, we will hit that number. And then as we get close to our subnet, then we'll continue counting up in increments of 8. So this is a time-saving element for the exam. Just bear in mind to remember what you're doing. So if you went, for example, from 8 to 40, don't put 80 as the next subnet if you're going past the host, if you get what I mean. So just remember what the technique you're using. So you'd start off 172.16.100.0. Now that isn't the first available subnet, it would be 0.0. But we're not being asked to do any designing here. We've got to quickly find this subnet. So I'll jump up from 8 to 80, because I know if I went up 10 times I would go from 8 to 80. And I'm going to jump up using an increment of 40, which I know is a multiple of 8 also. You can do this in longhand if you want, and then come back to doing it the quicker way later on. So I've added 40 here to get to 120, and we're getting very close to our actual subnet here. So we probably go up to 128 for our next subnet. And I'm pretty sure that our host is going to be in this subnet, actually, aren't we? Because if we add another 8 to that, we're going to get to 136. Yeah. So just for completeness, I'm going to show you the host address numbers. You could actually just tick the correct answer in the exam now and then move on to the next question to save time, because there's no extra points for working out. First host, last host, your broadcast will be the next subnet minus 1. It's a quicker way to work it out. So we've answered the question. Thanks for watching.